Hello and welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news in detail. Soon after making Chandrasekhar Babankule, former Maharashtra Energy Minister, as in charge of the Nagpur graduate constituency elections, Bharatiya Janata Party named Mayor Sandeep Joshi as its candidate for the upcoming elections. Nagpur graduate constituency comprising of 8 districts of Vidarbha including Nagpur, Wardha, Chandrapur, Bhandara, Gondia and Gadchiroli has around 1,83,000 registered voters. The election for this seat will be on December 1, 2020. BJP is holding the seat since 1962. Previously, Dr. Babban Rao Taiwade gave a strong fight to then-candidate Nitin Gadkari, now Union Minister and MP from Nagpur. Otherwise, it was a cakewalk for the BJP. Now with Congress declaring advocate Abhijit Vanjari, who had represented Nagpur University graduate constituency for 10 years and also been a management council member belonging to educational circle, is doing preparation for the election from last several months. Certain news agencies have flashed a report cautioning investors planning to invest their hard-earned money in the properties around Mihan. The properties allocated around Nagpur's Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar International Airport and Mihan are under DGCA's radar for various irregular deeds. Here is the list of the properties. Renuka Enclave, Deepika's, Arihant Arcade, Sri Samarth Asadguru, Shiv Swarup, Darvika's, Guru Raj, Samruddhi Pearls, Sai Enclave, Prasad Apartments, Saheli Girls Hostel, Kasturi, Ritika, Lakshmi Narayan Apartment, Ashirwad, Sugandh Apartment, Siddhivinayak Residentials 2 and 3, Krishna Apartment, Bal Prabha Manasi Royal, Sambhavi Cell Phone Mast, Sai Residency, Surendra Gharpure, Vrindavan, Digambar Darukar, Manohar Kumbhare, Nitin Kulkarni, Saket, Mrs. Hagwood Commercial Development Private Limited, Orbital Empires, etc. AGM company, which was trying to make huge profit in the digital advertising sector, has recently taken crores of rupees from investors not only in Nagpur but also in Madhya Pradesh. Sitapati police has registered a case based on the complaint of Nagendra Singh Bolinder Singh Thakur, a resident of Betul Ganj, Madhya Pradesh. The accused, including Sushil Ramesh Kole, Pankaj Ramesh Kole, and Bharat Shaho, in 2015, the Kole started a digital advertising business in Nagpur. The company is based at Civil Lines under the name of AGM Corporation. The company was into LED wall advertisement, hoardings, digital hoardings and light products business. The directors have also closed down their offices and fled after duping people of their hard-earned money. It is estimated that 30 to 35 crores rupees of investors' hard-earned money is in the possession of the fraudsters. Unidentified thieves broke into houses under the jurisdiction of different police stations and looted goods worth lakhs. The first incident theft took place at the house of Vandana Gaurishankar Jahare, 52 years old, a resident of Supare Nagar, Yerkheda in New Kamthi area. Vandana has a shop. She has locked the house as usual in morning and went for shopping. Meanwhile, an unknown thief broke the window and entered into their house. Gold and silver jewelry in the cupboard and rupees 50,000 cash totaling to rupees 1,33,060 was burgled when Vandana returned and learned of the theft. She informed police about the incident and lodged complaint. The second incident took place at the house of Ashok Jagdish Tiwari, a resident of Vrindavan Nagar under Yashodhara Nagar police station. Here thieves decamped with goods and valuable worth rupees 3,70,000. Cops have started investigation in both the cases. On Sunday night around 8 o'clock, the driver of a Maruti Bolero car going from Kalmeshwar towards Nagpur city suddenly lost control of his vehicle and hit a tree in Dahega, in which three occupants of the vehicle died on the spot of the accident. The injured person who admitted to hospital in Nagpur, a two-wheeler driver had died in an accident on the same route on the Kalmeshwar-Nagpur road around 15 days ago. Many potholes have formed on this route due to which occurrence of accidents has become a particularly regular affair. Although the local people have pleaded with the authorities regarding solving the issue, but their plea seems to have fallen on deaf ears. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBC News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very good care of yourself.